Count Dante was born John Keehan on February 2, 1939, in the South Side of Chicago. In 1967, he legally changed his name to Count Juan Rafael Dante, which according to him was his rightful title since he was an exiled descendant of Spanish royalty. Although he was actually born Irish, he insisted that his family fled Spain during the Spanish Civil War and changed their names in order to hide their noble heritage once in America. Needless to say, this is all bullshit. Count Dante was quite the character. Those who knew him described him as a large man who wore a purple cape, a freshly trimmed beard, yellow fishnet leotards, and a black gi. He was also known for walking around town with a lion cub on a leash. Throughout his life, he wore many hats. He was a hairdresser who owned salons. He would regularly be hired by Hugh Hefner to style the hair of Playboy bunnies. He also owned a string of pawn shops, and he was a main player in the 1970s Dojo Wars. But what he was mostly known for was his bogus karate manual called The World's Deadliest Fighting Secrets, which he sold in the back pages of comic books for $5 a copy. Yes, this is the deadliest and most terrifying fighting art known to man, and without equal. Its maiming, mutilating, disfiguring, paralyzing, and crippling techniques are known by only a few people in the world. This is the only book ever written on Dim Mak. An expert at Dim Mak, the most advanced form of Kung Fu, could easily kill many Judo, Karate, Kung Fu, Aikido, and Gung Fu, yes, Gung Fu, experts at one time, with only fingertip pressure. Using his murderous poison hand weapons, instructing you step by step through each move in this manual, is none other than Count Dante, the deadliest man who ever lived, the Crown Prince of Death, the undefeated Supreme Grandmaster of the fighting arts, winner of the world overall. Needless to say, Count Dante was quite the marketer, and he used his talents to host tournaments which actually benefited from his over-the-top promotion. For example, Bruce Lee showed up at one of his events. But sometimes he'd get carried away and let his big mouth get him into trouble. In one case, he claimed he could kill a bull with one punch. He even went around town with the bull on the back of his flatbed truck in order to promote the event. But when people turned up, he panicked and delegated his 19-year-old student to do the deed. However, the student bailed, leaving Count Dante alone to cancel the show by telling the crowd that, quote, the event was being shut down by the Chicago SPCA. Although he was a charlatan, Count Dante managed to convince himself that he was actually a badass. He somewhat famously went to Muhammad Ali's house and challenged the heavyweight boxing champion of the world to a fight. He also challenged the wrestling champion and the judo champion of the world, although none of those bouts ever came to fruition. Regardless of that fact, he still claimed that he was the world's deadliest fighting arts champion and master. Dante's pomposity managed to piss off the rest of the American dojos. Their major gripe was that Dante was running tournaments without the use of padding, and with an emphasis on full-contact kumite-style fights. They took their anger to the press and publicly admonished Dante for hosting tournaments which they called an insult to traditional karate. Dante responded by saying that he knew many black belts who wouldn't win in a street fight, and that the other dojos were teaching a watered-down form of martial arts. He ended his statement by saying, "Karate is for sissies." And now it's time to talk about the Dojo Wars. The Dojo Wars were comprised of two incidents. The first incident happened after Count Dante and Doug Dwyer, the second deadliest man alive, also the guy in this photo, got pissed drunk and decided to blow out the window of a rival dojo using dynamite caps. This brilliant plan ended with them getting arrested and charged with attempted arson. The second incident was a brawl between Count Dante's Black Dragon Fighting Society and the rival dojo Green Dragon Society's Black Cobra Hall of Gung Fu. The brawl between the two dojos ended with one man being killed. It started with Dante rounding up a posse and then heading off to the rival dojo. Once they got there, Dante kicked the door open and found six Green Dragons armed and ready for a fight. The incident was covered in a Black Belt magazine article called Chicago Memories and the Death of Jim Koncevic. According to the article, the room was full of men bearing Chinese weapons, maces, spears, swords, and knives. The article states that Dante said he was fighting for his life and pulling eyeballs out of the heads of opposing instructors. Just to be clear, Dante didn't pull any eyeballs out, but he did lacerate the eye of a rival instructor, causing an injury that would later require surgery. During the chaos of the brawl, Jim Koncevic was stabbed by a sword that was thrusted into his left side. After being stabbed, Jim yelled for the rest of the Black Dragon Society to get the fuck out of here, but Jim only made it three steps before dying in a pool of his own blood. According to the same article, Count Dante had been found by police hiding under a desk in the back office. There was a trial set, but all charges were dismissed by a judge who couldn't believe what he was dealing with. According to the Chicago Tribune, he called everyone involved a lunatic and told them, "You're each as guilty as each other." After the case was dropped, Count Dante vowed that his days of fighting at the drop of a hat were over, and that he would not accept any challenges unless he was attacked first. However, the Count didn't keep this promise. In fact, by all accounts, he became even more wild. According to his lawyer and friend, Bob Cooley, he beat two men up after they laughed at him. Bob witnessed another beating after someone called Dante a fruit. Bob also became a target after a disagreement which prompted Dante to claw his chin with a swipe that made Bob feel like his skin had been ripped off. Bob Cooley also mentioned that Dante immediately apologized and tried to make amends with a trick. Then Dante pulled out his gun, handed it to Cooley, and urged him to shoot it so he can catch the bullet. Bob Cooley refused and decided to avoid the Count after that. By the mid-1970s, Count Dante took a deep dive into obscurity. By this point, he was mixing booze and painkillers, and had attempted to host one last tournament, which ended in failure. John Keehan, aka Count Juan Rafael Dante, died 2 months later on May 25th, 1975, to a bleeding ulcer which caused internal hemorrhaging. His legacy lives on through the Black Dragon Fighting Society, which I briefly covered in my first video, How an American Ninja Tricked Hollywood. Anyway, thanks for watching and stay tuned for more weird stories.
ビジネス本。使えば使うほど広がる。オールデジタル。一等気が合う。オキのビジネス本。オキ。